Hello guys, KP Shamino here with my video for Russian Fishing 4. So on the 8th of January, so I can check it back, I bought my first Everest and you guys can now see that I can buy my second one. It's 9500. So I'm going to buy my second one. So it was not that hard because I didn't play a lot the game because I was more playing Hearthstone and Fishing Planet. But the thing is, I'm going to say to you guys, what did I do? What were the repair costs? What you need to check? And all that stuff. Because there is a lot of stuff that I want to share with you guys because I think this is the best method you can do. Is it the most fun? No, because you need to troll. You are going to get death too from the boat. It's sound the whole time. But the thing is, it's very boring, but this is the best way. It's not only that you catch a lot of fish, but the thing is, the fight is not hard because you can go with your boat behind the fish. So the wear on your gear is very low. If you compare it, I went to Bear Lake with my setups and I got very good feeding setups, but I came back. The first fish that I got on my Everest 20 kilogram mirror carp, it took me 15 minutes and yeah, it was just bullshit in my opinion. So the thing is, you need to troll. For me, Kiora Lake is still the best for the simple reason that you don't have catfish. You can troll on Sura, you can troll on Volkov too. It works really well, but I'm going to give you guys my tips. So you can see I got now 9500 again, so I can buy the second one. So the thing is, first of all, I'm going to start with with repair. So I only repaired my reel, my Everest, one time. So, and that was the mechanic. So you guys see, I didn't repair anything else on it. So I only got on my friction aware of 4.6, ball bearings 2.1 and spool. I'm very amazed about the ball bearings and the spool because if you check my gold, so you see here the spool is 4.7 and 5.8, but with the golds I'm fishing, I think, for 4 or 5 months. So I think it has to do something with the stars. So the bearings and the spool, they were a lot faster on the Everest than on the Gold 80. You guys can see it here because the Everest already on the half. And I don't put a lot of pressure on that reel because I only go with 28 kilograms compared to 22 kilogram drag. And on the Gold, I go with 25 compared to 14 kilogram drag. So you would think that the bearings were a lot faster on the gold, but that's not true. You guys can see it here, 5.8, 4.6 and already 2 on the Everest. So that's something that I saw. So what did I do? So on the Everest, I repaired only my mechanic at 20%. Why 20%? I know it need to be 30%. But the main problem is that I see a lot of people making guides on YouTube and on the forums. But They just stay with the basics, so 30% on mechanic, 50 on spool, friction brake, I think 20 or 30%. So, but they never calculate for what kind of fish you are fishing. So the time that you need to get the fish in. So that's worried me a little bit because that's not true what they are saying. They say the best chance to make the most money and to keep the repairs low is this. No, it depends on what fish you are going. So I feel if my Everest is a 20% mechanic, then I'm going on the bottleneck, I call it. So a Kiora Char, for example, of 14 kilograms take me 10 minutes more. So instead of 5 to 10 minutes, it takes me 20 minutes. On that moment, that's the bottleneck for me. On that moment, I'm losing time. So that means I'm losing money. So you always need to balance the time that you fish and the time that you can make money. So for me, that's 20%. So it's not really true. That's always 30. For example, if you go for catfish, I would repair a lot faster because it's going to take, instead of 20 minutes, an hour. Do you know what I mean? You need to feel that. So the moment that you are fishing and you think, oh, the fight is getting way too hard for my mechanic and it's damaged 10, 15%, 20%, it can be 30% too. Because if you fish for small fish, you can even go to 40% because it doesn't matter on that moment. So, but you need to feel it a little bit. I repair at 20%. I think it's a lot better than to wait to 30%. So that's what I'm saying. So I don't see that in the guides. They never calculate that in guides. It seems they don't fish. It's just Okay, 30% damage on the mechanic that you need to repair. It doesn't matter what kind of fish you are targeting. It doesn't matter, but it matters in my opinion. So that's a little bit the tip that I give to you guys. The mechanic repair was not a lot. If you compare it with the money that I made, it was 1200, the mechanic, at 21% on the Everest. So you guys can see it. My last video, when I bought the first one, that's like only 4 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago, I had 2000 silver. Now I got 9000 and a half again, and I did 2000 repairs because I need to repair my duties too and my gold 80s, of course, too. So that's all. So every 10,000 that you make, you only need to repair for 2000. So 8000 currency or silver you make very easy. And I didn't play a lot. If I play the same like I did the first couple of months on this game, I think I make easily each month 20,000 silver. So that's how easy it is. So that was a little bit a tip. Another thing, if you get more reels, so you guys see I got 3 duties. I got one of my buddy Blood, I need to say. He gave me this one. So I got always a gold 80 and a super duty in the repair. So you guys see here, this one. No, this is not the right one. So I think this one. So this is my backup setup. So this is totally repaired. You can see nowhere on the gold one, this one. So what do? I never stop fishing. I always got a very good rig ready with the gold 80. Now I even got 2 Everest ready. So always be sure that you are repairing one of the rigs. I got 3 rigs and one is always in the repair and with the rod 2. That you always can switch to a setup that is repaired. So very important. And this I use at night for the burbot and for the charts. So because at night it's not working. So I'm going to show you guys now my setup. So on the 3 rigs that I got. So the first one is the Siberia Gold 80. Then I'm going with the 25 kilograms. So now we are coming to the second point. Why trolling is very productive for this one. You don't need to pay a lot for the line because you don't need the meters. If you want to go for 350 meters, you are going to pay a lot more, but I don't need it. So this for the simple reason that I go behind the fish with the boat. So that's where you are going to save a lot of money onto the line. So because this is only, I think, 30 silver. If you want to go here 350, you are going to pay more than 100 silver. So it's all the bits that come together that makes it very productive to troll around. Then I'm going with the 22 kilogram leader and I'm going always with the hunter. It doesn't matter a lot which hunter, but of course 0-1 series are very good. Because the trout likes this a little bit more. If you go with the minnows, that's more for pike. I got all my pike. I got now 21 trophy pikes. And I got them all on the minnows. So always be sure that you get the hunter and get the minnow. So you will see it on my Everest. So here I go with the 22 kilogram. Once again, I don't need a lot of meters, 120 meters. Here I go with 30 kilogram. It's a little bit bigger setup. And here I go with the Blessed Funky Minnows. Be always aware that you put the berserkers on it. So you guys can see, I'm going here with the 4-0. But that are these are the berserkers, I think. So the 5-star hooks always, because you don't miss fish with them. That's the funny part about them. On the catfish, that's a really big problem, but don't do it. Just go with berserkers, 4-0. You can go 2-0-2. It doesn't matter a lot the hook size, I think, in the game. So, but I always go really big. Here you can see it. They already got the berserkers. Yeah, if you buy it. Therefore, those lures are very expensive. So, a hunter and a minnow. And then on my backup, if it is not in the repair, of course, I go with that's Texas rig. But the Texas rig, that's 80% bottom, spin fishing. So, this is for the night. So, for the you can get with this setup, you can get the burbot and the char. Be aware, you don't need to fish. You can just go with the Jing rig too. But I'm using the Texas rig. Because it's a little bit better. Okay. So, what do I need to say more? Yeah, I cannot say more, to be honest. So, you guys know the repairs. So, every 10,000, I need 2k repairs. The line is very important to be trolling. Because you don't need to get like a lot of line. Another thing that I saw, and I want to give you guys this tip too, is that If you see that you are not catching fish anymore, just go to another lake. Don't hesitate, just go to another lake. So I didn't play the last 3 4 days a lot. I came here, I went out of the the dock, and I got lake trout. So don't ask me why what he was doing there, but I don't think that they are not on specific places, those trophies. They are not even, so he was sitting here. Can somebody explain me why a lake trout in the day is sitting here, a trophy one? I don't know. I got more and more the impression that the trophies are just random. Because why I'm saying that for this check, if you check all the ratings, so I'm now around this number. So I think 39, if yeah, here 39. So if you check my trophies, so I got 17,000 fish and I got 66 trophies. So 17,066. Then I go to Radley. So he got 45,000 fish and 201 trophies. So he got more than double. So the thing is that this is all the percentage fish caught and trophies. You're never going to see here 1,000. There is not one guy. So here you can see the same. He's a little bit more fish caught, but his trophy number is just the same. So that means I don't think that the trophy fishing matters in this game. It's just the calculating. So every 5,000 normal fish that you get a trophy. So I don't think that that you can just go for it, because you would think that the first guy, he's now 37, so he got 37,000, so that's double of me, and he got a little bit more than double. But I never fish for small fish. I always am on Kiora Lake. That's a little bit harder. So you guys can see it. This is always percentage-wise going to be the same. I don't see guys that check once again. Do you see it? And that doesn't mean those guys cannot fish, because they are the top players. I know how you need to fish too, but you cannot manipulate this. So therefore, you sometimes see in the game that you do nothing and casual you got 2 trophies after each other. On that moment, the game just say, yeah, you need to get trophies to get your percentage right. So it's a pity, because that means that it doesn't matter a lot what you do to get the trophy. Because yeah, it's just a calculation in the game. You guys can check it out yourself. It's simple. I'm a simple man. I just always look at the info that I can gather. Here you see just the same. It's always the same. So there is not one guy that got like, check, he got a little bit more, but it's not. If there is like something behind it, that you can get trophies with skills, with knowledge, there would be a guy that got like 20,000 fish and 1,000 trophies, but that's not the case. You guys can see it here, 34. He got a little bit more. He got a lot of rares. The same with the rare. It doesn't matter, in my opinion. I can be totally wrong, but if I don't see a video where a guy explains me, now I'm going to get the trophy. He just go to a destination because they live there. He say that's the weather and that's that, and he get the trophy. Yeah, they can say what they want, but for me, it's just a calculation. Every now and then, you get a trophy, and that's how it works. So be sure, yeah, you can calculate it on that way. You can just say, yeah, it took me now 1,000 fish that I didn't get a trophy. So let's focus the Kiora Char. So the chance is bigger that I get a trophy. So you can manipulate a little bit that system, but that's what I think about that system. So it's a little bit a pity. Because that means that you cannot do a lot about it to get a trophy or a rare trophy. But yeah, that's how the system works, and I cannot do a lot about it. So that's a little bit my tips and tricks. I got my I'm going to buy now my second Everest. You guys got all the info. Trolling is the best what you can do in the game. That's how it is. So thanks for watching, guys. Have fun, and I see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.